concert today. I am actually going to cook for you, but we have some of our best YouTube friends with us. You hear the marvelous guitar of Ernest Kwok. Will play a couple of songs for us. Ernest doesn't know it yet, but he's here in Abingdon, England with us. And look here, inspired by my friend Zen, who is one of the most stylish and funny ladies on YouTube. And my makeup inspired by Julia, who is a makeup guru on YouTube. So we are all together today, and for you and for them, I'm going to make a no-knead bread. That's what you need with Christmas. You need quick bread so that you can feed the whole family and you are not standing in the kitchen for hours and hours and hours. And of course, it's almost Christmas, as you can see. So, I'm going to get started. This is so simple. You could even make it in your sleep. To start with white flour, I'm going to use bread flour, but you can use plain flour, any flour you wish. This is Christmas, we can do anything we want. We can look as silly as we feel like. We can even sing. But we have got to start cooking. So, 400 grams of bread flour. I already have 200 here, so another 200. And by the way, I don't measure anything in cups, because if you measure with scales, it's so much more accurate. So, there we go. Now I add 100 grams of plain flour, just because I feel like it. You don't have to. As long as you went with 600 grams of flour. Now another 100 grams of wholemeal flour, because it gives that rustic flavor which I love. So there you go. This is that simple, I tell you. Oh, and it's marvelous after such a difficult year to start feeling a bit of Christmas in the air. It's really amazing. This is water, 450 grams of warm water, still slightly warm, and 2 teaspoons of salt, which I will dissolve in the water, because otherwise I am afraid that it won't dissolve. And don't worry about 2 teaspoons of salt, because you'll cut the bread in so many slices that you'll hardly be eating any salt at all. And the salt preserves the bread as well, gives good taste, and we need salt to live, so that's all amazing. Now I'm going to add a little bit of extra virgin olive oil, which is perfectly optional. You can do it if you wish. If you don't wish, you don't do it. I add 1 tablespoon, some people add 1.5. You just do basically whatever you want and you'll have marvelous bread at the end of it. I promise. If you don't, you can always blame me. Your guests don't know me, so it all does not matter. And of course, we need yeast, otherwise your bread won't rise. Because I'm going to let the bread rise for a few hours, I don't need a lot of yeast. 1/2 teaspoon is enough. Here goes 1/4. Here goes
another quarter. So, there you go. And I thought that I would add a bit of sugar as well, which you don't have to. But you can. You can add basically anything you feel like. I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of brown sugar. So here we have 3 types of flour. You can use 1 if you wish. We have the olive oil, we have the sugar, we have yeast, and now I'm going to add the water. And it is as simple as that. There is nothing more to it than just mixing. If it seems too dry, add a bit more water. If it seems far too liquid, just add a bit more of flour. But this no-knead dough should be quite soft. And it all depends on the type of flour you used. So you let it hydrate. If you see a pan here, it's because we are going to bake our bread inside of what the Americans call a Dutch oven. Pan. So it might need a little bit more water. You don't need to knead, you just mix. And then you let it rest for a few hours. That's what I like to do. Sing a bit, cook a bit, forget what happened in this year, forget us all masked, forget the scares, forget everything, and just have a Merry Christmas. So that's all you need to do. Then I have a quirky way of letting my bread rise. I have just a rubbish bag. I like it because if the bread rises too much, it won't stick to my bag, so I do so. And I have no worries whatsoever. So, shall we put the baby to sleep? You can even leave all day, who cares? When you come back, you'll finish the bread. See you later. Bye. So, we are back again in our kitchen, Sir Colin and I. And don't forget, today I am my friend Zen. Look, Zen always looks ultra beautiful. And I have followed her fashion tips. I'll put the link to her channel in the text. See, I am learning a few things, Zen, with you. And
and becoming stylish myself and beautiful. And the makeup is inspired by my friend Julia. Bye, Julia! And I hope you'll all make this bread very, very simple. Of course, we have another friend with us, Ernest Kwok, who plays the guitar beautifully. I'll give you all the links in the text. It's great to have made such great friends. We are all a big family. And as you see, of course, today I'm not wearing an apron because this is a festive season, so we need to enjoy. Now, the bread has been rising in the oven only with the light on because it gives enough warmth for the yeast to rise beautifully. So come and have a look. It has been here now for over 3 hours, but you can just leave on the countertop all night if you wish. It doesn't matter. This is a very, very forgiving bread. More forgiving, it's only going to the bakery and buying it. This is even easier than going to the bakery because I don't need to put on my boots and go out. So, we are going now to set the oven at 230 degrees centigrade. The pan is empty and is going to warm up in the oven. And this is going to be an extra oven around our bread. So 230 for half an hour. And in the 30 minutes our bread is going to rise again. Almost Christmas and we are here in our kitchen together baking. Well, Sir Colin is filming and I know that a lot of people won't be together. My 93-year-old father lives in Portugal and of course I did not see him this year at all, so let's hope that next year we can go there. And if you can't be with your loved ones, I hope that at least you'll be able to see them on Skype or Zoom. It's not the real thing, but it's the next best thing. And we need to be thankful for small mercies. And as long as we are still healthy, I think there's a lot to be said for that. So we are just going to turn it around a few times, and what I then do, people have different ways of shaping their bread. I kind of pull over and over and over again. Don't use far too much flour, you don't need it. Then I'm going to shape into a ball and I'm going to put it to rise in this frying pan, or as our American friends say, skillet. So this is more or less done. The
is a joy to be listening to Ernest play the guitar so beautifully. Don't forget to always subscribe to as many channels as you can, because we all work very hard to keep our channels going and to come with a lot of interesting stuff. So, there we go. There is our bread. I had dusted the paper with a little bit of coarse yellow semolina because it makes it look kind of professional, but you don't have to. You can just put your bread on the parchment paper. I'll also dust it with a little bit of flour. That's what it is all about. Now our bread will rise for half an hour and then it will go in the oven, in the Dutch oven. We call it a casserole pan, never mind. But the Americans love to call it a Dutch oven. I'm partially Dutch and I had never heard of any Dutch oven. So, see you later. So finally our bread is going into the oven. There it goes. It has risen for the second time. I'm going to take the casserole pan or the Dutch oven out of the oven. It has been here for 30 minutes, warming up. So this is going to create an oven around our bread. It's very, very hot, so you need to be very careful. I'm going to make two snips. You can do it with a knife as well, if you so wish. Or you can do with the scissors. And you can do in several patterns. You just do whatever you want. I'm doing it very simple today. There goes our bread. I'm just going to put a little bit more flour on the top. Did I mention that the water you add to the bread needs to be lukewarm? If you want the bread to rise a bit faster, you add the water a little bit hotter, but never too hot or else it will kill the yeast. And if you need the bread to rise faster, you can also add a little bit more yeast than I did. So, there goes our bread for half an hour, 40 minutes. Then we'll take the lid out and we'll leave for another 10 to 15 minutes. And then we can eat it. Well, yay! We can't. No, hold your horses. Ooh. You should never cut the bread right when it comes from the oven, out of the oven, because it becomes all chewy. So set it on some kind of base and you can put it on the top of something else so that all the steam escapes. And you put the bread on the top, on the top of the stove would be all right as well. And you let it steam away for a while, then you break it.
you put some butter on it, and when the butter starts to melt, you eat it all in one go. Or at least Sir Colin well, because he's tall, so eats
and that, viewers, is a Lady Francesca top tip. Don't slice the bread as soon as you take it out of the oven. Don't forget.
Leave it for Sir Colin to munch on. Half an hour. No, 40 minutes, sorry, and we'll be back. We'll take out the lid and we'll leave for another 10 to 15 minutes. But as you see, the bread almost bakes by itself. We are going to start a bakery and the breads will appear from everywhere and we'll have no work at all.
Wonderful.
See you. So, we haven't seen our bread yet at all. This is going to be a surprise. Then we are going to remove the lid and leave it for 10 to 15 minutes to get a real good crust. So, well, let's have a look. One, two, three. Ooh, look here.
Wow.
Looks really amazing.
It does.
And now it is going back to the oven. We can put it back with the pan or just with the bread. I might just put it, the bread, so that it crisps up all around. But you can do whatever you wish. It's going to crisp it up and get a bit more color. And it is going to be the most amazing bread ever. Of course. So, another 15 minutes. And as you see, it seems like a lot of work, but as a matter of fact, I've been sitting in front of the TV and I've been singing carols and eating chocolates and doing a lot more stuff that had nothing to do with bread. So we'll be back. See you later. Here we are again. I feel like one of those ladies who is showing you the newest cars, or the magician or something, but this is true magic. Look, our bread. Isn't this truly amazing? No need, no hassle. Just a quick, most amazing bread in the world. I'm now going to let it cool off for a bit and then we'll cut it to show you how amazingly crunchy this is. Just listen here. It's hollow, it's completely baked. But now it needs to cool off for a little while. So I'll leave it here and we'll come back again. See you in a little while. I'll have a new job in some car sales
showroom,
especially Bentley, Jaguar, Mercedes, something expensive. See you later.